You come across a small settlement, or at least what typically passes as one for scavengers. It is shabby and dark, and smells of rotten flesh. You see people sitting around a badly made fire. There are a few kids, thin, feral-looking. Some grown-ups with visible ailments such as skin growths, missing limbs, scabs, coughing up blood, and such. Some of the people have weapons. 5 by your count. The settlement goes quiet, and a small group approaches you with weapons drawn. A middle-aged, heavy-set woman rolls in from behind the armed group and speaks, her voice distorted by scabs covering her lips and face.
Who are you, then? You come to stick us.
The woman in charge spits and curses the bandits.
You good flesh folks, you never too clever. But I guess I was wrong about you. Be thanking you. We go, quickly.
Thank you. You finally enter the Red Cave, and you now realize the meaning of its name. The walls and floor are rough, layered with blood-red moss and black veins. Faint crimson light lingers beneath this odd canopy, pulsating quietly in slow rhythm. He stares, his mouth wide open and eyes lit up, and gestures for you to move forwards. You move through this odd tunnel and find several paths, some leading to small alcoves that are clearly used by the bandits as storage. Other paths are entirely collapsed. The only remaining way leads to what looks like an entrance to another larger tunnel, but there is a membrane blocking your way. You examine the structure of this barrier and sense ancient weaves of magic combined with a life of its own, as well as the artifice of dwarves. Through magic, you can weaken the weaves and thus hopefully walk through. Although magic and other mysteries are clearly at work here, you also spot the unmistakable craft of dwarven smiths. You uncover the mechanism that should open the barrier, but it will not be easy to master. Carefully, you study the ancient mechanism, and with much care, you find the right combination to make it work. The barrier opens, allowing you to enter. You stand in a dark chamber, covered still in the strange moss, but here, you see a deep hole in the middle, the earth and stone around it torn from within. And from this hole, cracks spread out like the sun's rays. They are small here, yet you see bright light within, and you sense enormous power within, pulsating, spreading. And yet, from your divine connection, you also sense that this is a mere outlet, not the source.
Fascinating. I've heard of such things. Of course, inanimate yet living is not a thing of myth in Slavia. No, but at this scale? This cave, it has residues of great power, but also echoes of life. Alas, I admit, I need help if I am to solve this. Unless you happen to be a dwarven stonemaster, or perhaps an ancient who still remembers, no. We need to search for an expert. I will, of course, remain here, study this cave more.
That is an excellent question. I would wager that traveling to the lands of stone and metal where dwarven survivors now dwell is a sure bet. Now, you could also look for some elder longears, elves that is. Once they're old enough, the likelihood that they meddled in the affairs of the world grows exponentially. Find them in ancient forests, and who knows, maybe goblins or orc know something. Just remember to find their villages, not just random folk. Failing that, I do know a place, but it will be a matter of brute force and likely much more difficult. A dwarven smith of great renown is held captive by trolls. I happen to know where. Go, free him, and he will be honor-bound to aid you.
Thank you.